Increase your collagen at home by 400%. And yes, this is scientifically proven. This easiest is probably the only one you need. You see, that's a threat to most clinics, of course, but not for me. The more my patients do at home, the happier I am. I'll prove this today, and yes, it really is under $8. I'll give you exact details and how to do it, what to avoid, and absolutely everything you're going to need to be successful with this. So, increase your collagen by 400% in under 6 weeks, under $8. And here's the best part. It's all natural and it only takes 5 minutes. Now you're gonna love this, once a week. There's nothing to buy in this video from me. There's no affiliate links. You can get everything you need on Amazon and you can probably have it within hours depending on where you live or with 1 day. That Prime delivery, it's a bit crazy. Have you seen those drones? They deliver it down. Let me know if you do that to get these products, but it's not expensive. That's the point. As always, this is not a sponsored video. I don't accept any money for my videos. This is my hobby. I actually have a full-time job seeing patients, real patients in real life, teaching and training globally. So, does that check all the boxes for you? I hope so. But I do give you a lot of free information, and if you like this video and the ones that I give you, please subscribe. And in fact, I found that only 30% of you benefiting from my information and 25 years of experience are actually subscribed. It helps me bring you more and more in-depth videos. If you want to next level it, there's a little button under here, a little bell. Click that and you'll be notified when the newest video goes live so you can stay ahead of everyone else in your skincare journey. I did say a 400% increase in your collagen. So if you walked into an office like mine, where I charge, and I have been in clinic all this past week, charging $1,000 a pop for, say, RF, radio frequency, or energy-based microneedling, and you ask for this $8 solution, and you wanted 400% collagen boosting, they'd send you running. You see, that's a threat to most clinics, of course, but not for me. In fact, the more my patients do at home, the happier I am, the better off I am. Why would that be, do you think? Well, my patients are actually walking billboards, and that's an important point. And when you decide who you're going to follow on social media, consider that. Now, this blew my mind, and it will yours too. And the thing is, I actually know better. I learned a valuable lesson while researching for this video. But this research I knew. I shared it long ago, like over 12 years ago, and again 3 years ago with a simple dermaroller. But I don't think I pounded the table enough. And today, in these 10 minutes, consider the table pounded. Now here is the study. Here is the science. So you can see here, research has found skin treated with 4 microneedling sessions, 1 month apart. So you now have a dose. And look at this, could lead to a 400% increase in collagen. So let's go look at the specifics. Okay, so here it is, and the principal mechanism of action. This is important because I always talk about PRF and what we're doing with regenerative medicine. And look at the growth factors, particularly same ones we see with PRF and how we microneedle that in. Platelet-derived growth factor, transforming growth factor, alpha. And we have FGF too, which is fibroblasts. Of course, you guys know that because that produces collagen and elastin. But let's see, where do we get the 400%? You can read through the study. It's actually quite interesting. Fibronectin matrix forms after 5 days of injury that determines the deposition of collagen, resulting in what you want, skin tightening, persistent for 5 to 7 years. That's crazy. But of course, you know, if you collagen bank, if you maintain your collagen, you get to keep it. Histological examination of the skin revealed with 4 microneedling sessions, 1 month apart, shows 400% increase in collagen and elastin deposition at 6 months post-operatively. The healthier you are, probably the longer you do it is more chance of getting there. But even with these 4 sessions, people had the deposition of collagen. Now, you all want to know about scar tissue, and this is microneedling without energy, let's be clear, using just the needles. Look here, collagen fiber bundles appear to have a normal lattice pattern, rather than parallel bundles as in scar tissue. So the way the collagen deposition occurred was much more like your regular natural, remember I said in the top of the video, natural collagen deposition than that of scar tissue. You might get scar tissue, of course, a little bit with things like Sculptor, with Bellafill, with energy devices, Hi-Fu, Thermage, RF microneedling, but this is a benefit for here for you au naturel people. I've had RF microneedling, I've had lasers, I've had some, I've had Althera once, so I'm not afraid of that quote unquote scar tissue everyone is, but for you people that are, and I know some of you want more natural, and I did a post the other day, age gracefully, whatever that means, this might be more for you. So I've offered microneedling of some sort in my practice for 15 years, way back to the time where when you're using those powered pens, you had to change the tip of the pen when you wanted to change the depth. Now we just rotate it and it goes deeper or less deep. But now I know you're going to ask, there's so many types. Do I use a roller, a stamp, an electric pen like this one that I use in clinic? And yes, there are even air blowing kind of pens that blow air in and can blow product in deeper just by using air and no needles. And of course, don't forget the old school nappage kind of by hand technique for mesotherapy. What do I mean by nappage? Well, here's what I was doing in Korea a few weeks ago. This is intradermal injections of Korean skin boosters. And you can see I'm using a stamp or a injection needle. But much of this can be replaced or better yet enhanced by a simple roller, the dermal roller, without any fancy slip. So we talked about all the different kind of stamps or microneedling pens or devices you can get. Here is the exact one that was used in this scientific study. Now here's the exact DermaRoller device as an example only that you can buy for $7.99. Now here is the exact device that I give my patients. Now you'll be tempted to buy this one for $14. It's an upright stamp. Or you might be tempted to buy this one for $16. It's a stamp that has a canister in it that will release a fluid when you stamp it on the face. But trust me, this easiest DermaRoller is probably the only one you need, or the one at least to start with, and the one that was shown to have a 400% improvement in collagen. So you don't need to get fancy here. That's my point. Now, yes, here is the micro pen, the electric one that I use in my clinic, and you'll see bloodied up pictures of people. And remember, you don't have to go that deep. However, why we use these in clinic that go deeper, we are trying to get into the fat layer, which isn't what you're trying to do here. I'm using PRF or blood draw, growth factors, stem cells, and exosomes that come from your own body, and I am putting them into your fat layer. That's different than what we're talking here with the DermaRoller. So no, you don't need to see your face pinpoint bleeding. Here I'm talking about 0.2 to 0.3 millimeters depth. Now let's talk a little bit about how do you do it. Well, you want to take one finger and you want to tension the skin and you want to angle the face for underneath the submentum or angle it if you're looking in the mirror properly so you can see the area. Take your time at first, especially around the eyes. You don't want a corneal abrasion. So it might take you 10 minutes to do it the first time around, but you'll get to where it only takes 5 minutes, like anything, you know, hand-eye coordination and practice, you're going to get quicker. But at the end of the day, it's going to be about 5 minutes once a week. And to that note, LED masks, of course, they supercharge your mitochondria of your fibroblasts that are going to produce your collagen and elastin. So people using red light, and you can use it just before you microneedle or before you dermaroll, that's going to supercharge your cells. Now, you do need to use it correctly. So let's talk about depth. Now, under the eyes, the skin is different, of course, from the preauricular area or the lateral cheek here. So you want to look at the skin layers in depth. How do you keep it simple? Well, you simply just do one or two passes to the lower eye area, whereas you can do multiple passes to the edge of the cheek. In clinics like mine, often we'll go to up to a 0.5 roller laterally here, and then 0.2 to 0.3 under the eyes. So if you really want to get into this, you could have rollers at different depths, and a good combo, therefore, would be a 0.2 to 0.3 and then a 0.5. Those complement each other quite well. Now, what slip should you use? What topical should you use? Well, you don't have to technically use anything. You could cleanse your skin, allow it to dry, and start your rolling. It's the mechanical stimulation that's important. Yes, microchannels are opened, and they are open for about 10 minutes after rolling. And I use growth factors, so I give my patients a kit that has the roller between 0.2 and 0.3 millimeter, and it has growth factors. It comes in one kit. But if you're on a budget, you don't have to use any slip at all. Now, you want to be mindful. You don't want infection. You don't want to share your roller. You don't need to get deep into the blood level. You don't need to see blood coming from the face when you do this. And if you are using a slip, please use one that's sterile and meant for microneedling. You can get granulomas along with the infection. And what a granuloma is, we see that with injections like Sculptra or the old Belafils, where the particle size gets into the body tries to fight it off, so you get white cells and you get granulomas, you get an inflammatory response, and you can't get rid of the foreign body. And so you get lumps and bumps under the skin. You don't want that. You don't want to just take your hyaluronic acid or otherwise your retinols off the shelf and try and microneedle them in. That's called a disaster. Of note here, just like lip fillers, some people get a little bit and then yes, they think a lot is going to be a lot better. And we know that's not always the case. So don't get tempted to say, oh, I'm going to 1 millimeter, 2 millimeter, even 3 millimeter depth rollers are available. You don't need that. More is not better. More consistent is better. In fact, the clinical paper in 2008 showed that even if you needle deeper, you don't produce any collagen deeper than the dermal layer anyway. And the dermal layer is superficial, so there's no need. Now, for you geeks out there, how does this actually work? Well, microneedling causes a low level of trauma to the outer layer of the skin. This prompts the skin's healing process that leads to skin regeneration and to the production of anti-aging substances within your body. It's a bioactive cascade for collagen and elastin production from your fibroblasts. That's why adding red light to these type of treatments is actually very beneficial because it speeds up that whole process. I recommend after microneedling, then you can wait 5 or 10 minutes and apply a moisturizing healing type of a product. I use my Ultra Moisture. You can use hyaluronic acids. You can use vitamin C's if you're used to using them. You can even use retinols after, especially if they contain vitamin C's like THD ascorbate that aren't going to be causing any reactions to the skin. You'll get to know your skin over time, so you're going to have to play with this. There's no one cookbook for everyone, and it's not always the same. Avoid hot showers after, and for 24 hours, avoid vigorous exercise for most people. Now, how would you clean a roller like this? Well, the rollers that I give to my patients and that are in my kits, the one that you're going to get that I showed you that's under $8, they all last about 8 to 10 treatments, and they stay sharp for that long. You can simply clean it with an alcohol swab. You want to look for 70% isopropyl alcohol, and you can spray it on and clean it with gauze. You'll find that in any local store, department store, drugstore. It's very cheap, and it'll last you a long time. There you will see over 90% available there, but we found that the 70% actually has more antibacterial qualities and properties. So now the 100% guaranteed question you're going to have, when am I going to see results? Well, let's look back at the studies and the data, the science to guide us. Now, no doubt, as a general rule, the longer you carry on rolling, this dermarolling, the more likely you are to see a difference. Consistency, just like your topical skincares, is key. But you want to take stock at about 6 to 12 weeks of regular dermarolling. That's the sweet spot, and that's been shown within the studies. You should take some before and afters. That's what I would say. Share them with us. We'd love it. We do that with our LED masks and some of our products. You can put it on our site, and that way you are sharing your own pictures with our community here. It helps people out. You guys are better taking before and after than many of the clinics and even the surgical clinics. I hate to say it, but a lot of the before and afters you know online are often trickery with lighting and different changes, different angles. So for your own use, if nothing else, take your pictures initially and then at 6 and then again at 12 weeks. Now, it's important to keep in mind, if you're looking for, say, acne scarring results, well, yes, you might have to go a little deeper. You might have to wait a little longer. And again, if you come in with skin that's somewhat untaken care of or unkept or more photo damage, or you're just starting your journey and you're in your 60s or 70s, it's going to take you longer to see results than someone, say, in their 30s or 40s that didn't get as much sun damage, that's using great skincare, retinols, glycolics, LED masks. I'm always perplexed at why everyone wants to say, hey, show me before and after, show me before and afters. From companies or clinics, they're never going to show you a bad before and after, of course, but I know people love to see them. Just understand, no one with a motive is going to show you a before and after that isn't amazing and the best of all the results they've gotten. So aside from the studies, how do I know this works? Well, I do 3D imaging in my clinic and I've done so for over 15 years. I can measure skin laxity, lifting vectors like this one. Lifting. I did say that dirty word that most surgeons don't want you to believe can happen without a surgical facelift. But here's proof from one of my patients who didn't have surgery. In fact, I have many, hundreds and thousands of these photos. Do you see these little arrows on the face? Well, those are lifting vectors that compare the before to the after. You click a button and it shows me where the face is lifted and maybe where it's drooped. Yes, it's a $20,000 camera, but that's important to add to the science of the studies, the science of real life practice. You're now going to want to watch this playlist all about LED and red light masks so you can boost your fibroblasts, the energy of your fibroblasts, because they help produce collagen and elastin. That's what keeps you youthful. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.